She can't sing.
Why you always trying to get a nigga singing? She always trying to get a nigga singing, cuz.
The real words and all that.
But this is TwinPurp.
Alvin Joe, I write the second.
Oh, the second.
Now it's the second. Grandpa. The second. Salute.
Hey, Grandpa. Excuse me. So, we're here today to talk about bars.
Bars. What are bars to you, first of all? Bars. Yeah, let me ask you that. What are bars to you?
What are bars to me? Okay, first of all, bars are composed of a combination of things. Aside of just the English language, just other languages can be incorporated.
First of all, because I see she's going to take a long to get to the point. Just because you're not speaking on a positive subject don't mean you don't have bars. Let me say that right then and there. And we're talking about rap bars here, ladies and gentlemen. For those who don't know what bars are, because everybody says, you got bars, you got bars. You ain't got no substance, you ain't got no... You can talk about experience you went through in life using words and put it in a creative form to display the bars that you do have. But they still fight it because it's not, you know, we're not being hypocrites. You know what I mean? Talking about one thing, but living another.
Forget about even the subject matter or the theme. What are bars? So we're gonna break it down. Like he said, subject matter. There's theme. There's genres. There's a combination of things that that bars are composed of. The English language. Grammar.
It's wordplay.
Wordplay. Rhyming. Wordplay.
Not nursery style, though. You know, using words that, you know, people normally don't use, that's considered, for a lack of a better term, ghetto, ratchet, you know what I mean? Stuff like that.
So just because you don't have an MBA or a bachelor's, like some of us here speaking on the subject matter, doesn't mean that you gotta hate because your comprehension level is smaller than that of a mouse. So, back to the cat in the hat and green eggs and ham, because you don't know a thing about, I don't know. Name a good book. What's the last great book that you've read lately?
It depends what you call great. I don't know, like, I have a different
Well, let's talk about a book we both like that we care for. Does that take away or discredit the fact that we were able to read it and that it was more complicated than Green Eggs and Ham?
This is a special ASLELS challenge for you, Floyd. If you can read one full page of a Harry Potter book, nigga, I'll give $750,000 to whatever charitable organization you want to. Fuck the bucket of ice, man. I had a phone call from my man Jimmy Kimmel. Jimmy said if Floyd accepts the challenge, that he'll put it on the actual show so you can read it on the show. We don't want to put pressure on you. We know you can't pronounce those words in that Harry Potter book, so we're gonna let you read Cat in the Hat.
She's funny, my nigga. Like, she's funny as hell. Why are you trying to cut my nigga like that?
I'm just being current. You know, some of you guys are like praising all these back in the day rappers who quote unquote have bars, has been. But where are they now? There are niggas who are dead and still make numbers more than a lot of yous today's. So before you discredit bars. Think about that. I'm not gonna drop any names, but you might see a couple of videos or pics fly through the screen or something.
Don't do that. Don't do that. Here, this is what it is.
Matter of fact, just because you can't read Green Eggs and Ham doesn't mean you can't have a $72 million ticket. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
I'm just saying. Ouch. Does it matter? Does that make you any smarter than the next motherfucker? Because I remember. There are blind people who can't physically read with their eyes, but can read with their fingers and are a lot more, you know, financially stable than some of us. So I'm just saying, don't discredit folks because they can't physically read with their eyes.
Well, let me tell you that financial stability doesn't make you a good person.
No, but we're talking about the whole.
Doesn't give you a pass to get into heaven. Let me just say that right then and there. Just being financially stable. What we need to stop being, hypocrites. We need to stop being closed-minded to other people's music. We need to start, you know, having a conversation with certain people, get to know those people and see where they're coming from, know how they live their life, and how they became greater than a fucking war story. Because all my shit is war stories, unrelatable music.
Unrelatable music.
But,
yeah, on that note, we're just saying, you know, don't discredit folks for what they are. And success does not talk about, does not discriminate against your ability to read, your ability to compose words, what's coming out of your mouth. But more importantly, your actions, because your, you know, your actions.
Let me ask you this. What is your best bar that you think you spend? Like, that's a bar. That's a bar.
Oh, I ain't got bars. Let everybody know. I ain't got bars. You know what I'm saying? I ain't got no bars. But I see you guys are watching and listening.
I seen something the other day on my time feed, on my news feed. It says, Kanye West says, Tupac is the most overrated rapper ever.
I didn't
click on and read the link though. That's
no, so
I don't. I seen that, but you know, speaking of that, Pac is my favorite rapper. That's just me. He just the way he did his thing. He just touched my heart and how he did his thing, and then his rap, his lyrics I can rap along with and feel it. You know, so it depends what we like. You know what I'm saying?
More importantly, just since we're on the Tupac topic, I just wanted to point out to you all people, Google it if you like. UC Berkeley has a degree. You can have a degree on Tupac. So, I mean, you can have bars all you want to. You can sell records all you want to. You can call someone the best all you want to. But let's just break it down to some people who don't know it. Pac is the best.
That's your personal opinion.
And he's on all different levels. He's kind of said it. You're teaching my brain. I'm like, you know what I'm saying? Like, E equals MC squared right now. I'm just saying.
You know what the funny thing about everything, like, because everybody was like, who did you grow up on? Like me, I didn't grow up on Run DMC, Sugar Hill Gang, Curtis Blow, or any of those East Coast rappers. I grew up on Too Short, Mac Dre, Sebo. Those are my top three, and E-40. Those are my guys. That's who I grew up on. I grew up on Nat. I grew up on JT the Bigger Figure, San Quinn. And San Quinn is only but 2 years older than me, but I grew up on his music, you know what I mean? So, it like, the independent game, which everybody is on now, the Bay has always been on it. And these are the artists who's doing that back then when everybody's trying to do now, you know what I mean? But
oh, let's just first go on there with the Bay Area when people talking about bars. I would like to point out that the Bay Area is second in the lead with regards to the music influences and radio on the charts. If you don't believe me, if you've been to radio music school and all that, look it up.
Probably because we got Green Day.
Well, New York and the Bay. Yeah, too. But New York and the Bay is New York's in first place, obviously because of the size of their market. It's a lot larger because of population. So if we were in the lead with the same amount of population, we'd probably be on top. And then comes the Bay. So if you don't believe me, tune into iHeartRadio and click onto all the radio music channels there and just start listening to the Bay Area music in the radio that hits the air. And when it flops, it won't hit Los Angeles. When it does well, it will hit Los Angeles, because Los Angeles does not influence music. And if I'm wrong, then why are we having Fabs and DJ Mustard's going at it?
Push this in!
Because the reality is, our music does influence everybody else's. So bars or no bars, we don't get no 360 deals. We're not with it. We're not going to. This is why we're doing our show independent.
Independent. The question you need to ask yourself, what are bars to you? And who's your favorite rapper?
And why?
And why? That's because we don't discredit your personal preference towards a certain individual. Not at all. We will listen to your story, listen to your side, and we'll say something like, that's interesting. And want you to elaborate more on the situation.
Or think like we just said, why do you really like it? Did you like the actual sound that's coming out, the beat? In other words, is your head going like this to the beat or to the lyrics? Because that tells me your comprehension level was low. Your comprehension level was low.
But if you like the lyrics.
Because if you heard the lyrics, then you'd be cool with some country music.
Yeah, sure, that country music, they got bars.
We're just saying. When we start the link,
what's
that
channel?
Content.
That 92, they got 0.3.
Yeah,
One of the other channels out here in Los Angeles be when they play all that other music that's not the hip hop, because I understand. Oh, you know, hip hop, too much booty shaking, woo woo woo, club. Well, maybe it's because people be working hard and they just want to have fun when they get to a certain point in their life when it's their time. So they might not want to hear no knowledge all the time, especially if they have good jobs and knowledge all day. They may want to have a reckless moment and go out and fuck with the young thugs.
Did a lot of shit, just live this here lifestyle. Straight from the bottom to the top, my lifestyle. Nigga, living life like a beginning, this is only beginning. Nigga, I'm on the top of the mountain, puffing on clouds, and nigga, still beginning.
And that's what you want to do.
And Amigos music and all that type of stuff, just to have fun. Like, but you know, we have to use it towards whatever it's supposed to be used for, not give it a whole. Just because you hear it more, don't give it the whole general, this is the music game today. Because you have the choice to push play on what you want to push play on, which is understood.
Even more importantly, if you're seeking knowledge, you have the opportunity, like everybody else in this country, to go out and seek it. With the internet and the radio, the radio is established to entertain us on our free time. If you want to go to school, you should walk onto the university. There's so many of them. I'm just saying. Nowadays, you can even log on online if you're lazy like that. So you could be a couch potato and get a degree. I went to school, walked on there, and did the whole shebang. But if you want to have your little brother do your math because you're stupid and sit behind a computer and tell me you earn money, I'm just saying, that's how people compose their thoughts. They think music itself is weak. My music is weak. I say to you, if my music is so weak, why did you take the time to tune in? Ask yourself that.
No, they don't like my music either, which is understood because I live an extravagant life without having millions in my pocket. I had extravagant experiences without having millions in my pocket. I've done a lot. I don't want to expose myself on camera, and that is the past. But listen to Unrelatable, Volume 1 through Volume 7, and that's all I'm talking about. I grew up on Too Short.
Me too.
Too Short. Oh, you hear me? I wanted to be like Too Short when I was a little kid. I was listening. My dad allowed me to, because I grew up with my father raised me. He knows Too Short is my dude. So
name a song.
Cuss words.
You like Stips?
Oh, now see, you're getting a little bit personal.
No, well, I'm just trying to figure out.
He is not jazz.
Well, maybe you're not Too Short's girlfriend. Maybe you're just a groupie backstage.
And who are
you? Maybe you're just a freak bitch.
Now let's sing this dirty shit.
So you motherfucking style is gonna change my style.
To all you bitches, hoes, and all that shit. Here's another rap that I'm ready to spit. It goes like this, my name is Short. I'm tearing shit up like never before. Pimp, slaps, making snaps. Cold cash money and Too Short raps. Oakland, California, that's where I'm from. The city where the boys say you don't want nothing.
We got dope fiend beat. We can go back, I'm talking about back then when I grew up, like 86, 85. That Born and Mac album. All that type of stuff.
I was still learning
the Dope Fiend beat, all that shit, man. I grew up on that. So when I got a chance to ever do music, of course I'm gonna cater my style towards that, because I wasn't raised off like no positive influences, because we had them, but they weren't rapping. And then what we were seeing out there in the streets, this was people that was having things, that were doing a certain thing in life. And of course, those will become to be our role models and what we want to look after. But ever since, but if you look at my life, you can just Google me, my Armand Clifford Wainwright, I did the right thing in life. So I wasn't influenced by anything. I still went my own way, did my own thing, played basketball, went to school and all that. That's neither here nor there. That's to show you that I wasn't misguided and undecided by the people I grew up on listening to.
I too listened to Too Short, even though I was a female.
She liked me 40 though.
I love you 40. You know, Robert Forte.
Keep the Sneak.
You know,
I'm speaking on the CDs that she has that I seen that she went out.
There's nothing wrong with seeing Kick the Sink. I do this to the beat.
Yeah, three times
I can't
crazy.
Understand a nigga what he said. But
three times crazy.
He
yeah,
does
that was
this.
A part of my upbringing.
So, does three he have bars? If I could understand, I'd be like, oh, my nigga got bars. But, you know, I'm just saying.
I feel you don't have to have bars if you're telling the truth and narrating your life.
And if it makes sense, it makes sense. You feel me? So I'm just
me, I do have bars with me narrating my life using big words is fucking y'all up.
Because they can't comprehend it.
Nah, they got to. They understand. They understand. Yeah. It's just my subject matter.
You know what's funny? Half of you motherfuckers can sit there and have bars all you want to, but y'all can't spell them. If I did a spell check on your fucking pages and on your notebooks and all that shit, bitch, y'all all stupid. Cause they just pull out the web, we all know what backpack rappers, you pull out the thesaurus and the dictionary and all of a sudden you think you're wavy. If I ask you what the fuck the word meant.
And what they go do at the end of the night?
Some
of them, no. Smoke weed, go against everything they talked about.
Yeah,
they had it Ferguson. All y'all should have been frontline. Any type of situation that we need to be, revolutionary, y'all should be on the front line. Why I never see none of y'all, man. You know? And here's another thing. People be talking about music today, music back then, motherfuckers is confused of what the fuck they want to do. They wanted to stop the killing. Tupac and Biggie after that. Let's stop the killing. We all need to get along. Everybody gets along. And then now, 50 came out back to some motivated more to violence in the music, street music. And then everybody gets back along, and now everybody's saying everybody's too buddy-buddy and too... What the fuck do y'all want, America? Do you want us to be peaceful and get along, or do you want a competition, war, whatever? You gotta understand, a lot of these motherfuckers are sensitive. They can't have motherfuckers coming at them. If they can't come back verbally like they can come back, they don't come back by it. You know what I mean? So what do we want? Do we want peace and music? Everybody getting along, or do we want competition and violence? Because it has to be one or the other. It will not be both. It will not be nothing's in the middle.
And mind you, on that whole violence and thing and music, let's just get it straight. Was nobody really saying I'm gonna physically or I'm gonna go out and get a gun and shoot you? Mind you, rap music in itself, it was a battle all the time. Pac and Biggie put it on wax. So if you got something to say, put your shit on wax.
He came back with the song after he hit him up.
He never said his name, but
the national anthem is the most violent song in America if you ever break down the lyrics and listen to it, and that's our fucking nation's anthem. So if we really want to go back and get deep about everything, we can do that. Do you know your Bible?
And if they really want us, they really want us to be positive, why are they taking away some of those songs we're singing in school? Some of those songs speak about religion. I got to pull up the song so I can play it for you. But I remember when I was a kid, we had to sing this song, and it said something about, you know, religion of some sort, God, at one point of the word. And I went to, you know, a school right there off of Fruitvale in Oakland, California, Hawthorne Elementary, you feel me? And we knew all the songs, I forgot everything. But anyway.
Who is your favorite rapper? And why? Who's your favorite rapper? Huh?
Alvin Joe.
Who's your favorite rapper, though?
Okay. Before that, it was Tupac.
I never get my nigga.
Oh, well, there's one other person that I did do exclude at times. I don't think I get enough credit, but I've always been a fan of Twista.
That's what's up.
Because he's lyrically inclined. He has his own style. He has his own. If you had to put him in a genre, he'd be in a category of himself. And that's why I care for E-42.
Yeah,
they're kind of like their own little categories. So
me, I would say Mac Dre and SIBO. I was some nigga, they had the real street music. Mac Dre is just a Mac Dre type of big character. And SIBO just had some of the real street music ever, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? I fuck with SIBO. You know, Too Short, I always wanted to be like Too Short when I was younger and all that. But
well, let me ask you this.
Yeah.
Who's your favorite female rapper?
I told you, Lil' Kim. Lil' Kim. I feel will forever be. When I first heard Lil' and that poster. Yeah. Cause I was like, these type of women exist, saying this and acting like this and okay with it. It ain't like when you try when you're younger, you had to try to have sex with a girl in high school, she's hiding under the covers, you couldn't look at nothing, and she's all open like, nigga.
Yeah, she didn't care. I know the first time I actually saw this, my parents didn't really let me see and do all that, cause I learned about this shit on my own in school, friends, all that. So I had a science project for a physical science class. It was me, Dominique, and I think Brandon and this little Asian chick, I forgot her name. Anyways, we had to meet at Dominique's house. And I just remember walking in this nigga's room, and they had two beds right there, and then this big ass poster, that's the one you're talking about. Her legs is wide open, and I'm like, OMG. But, you know, it wasn't a shock, it was just more so that it was proof in itself that, yeah, like you said, it exists, but men love it, they want it.
The greats of Tupac, Biggie, Jay-Z, and Nas. Those, their names is always in the discussion. And it's whatever order you want them to be on. Me, I have a different order. For that order, for that group, this is what I do. For me and that group, out of those guys, I have this on some real shit. Nah, hey, Pac first for me. This is just for me. Pac first for me, Hov, Biggie, and low-key, Nas never connected with me. I'll just leave it like that.
Well, my order, point blank, period, it wouldn't even be a rank. It would be more kind of like a chain of command. You put Pac right there and the rest of the motherfuckers right beneath him in one level. And the reason why, it's obvious. They all have something that he had, but they didn't all have everything that he had. So that's the difference. He has it all, and they didn't have it all. And if you really break it down, he can get political. Like I always say about
ain't none of them revolutionary political like that.
And we can all, they all, you know, Nas tried or whatever. But
maybe it was bars and street shit.
But like if you look at, if we just want to analyze the one that made hits, All Eyes on Me, January of 2006. 6 months in advance, already had hit double platinum.
Yeah, he did that album two weeks after when he got out of jail.
All of those songs, in addition to follow the Machiavelli album. But with that said, if you really analyze the whole CD, every single song was a little different. He had something for everybody to smoke on, to choke on, you feel me, for the bitches. You feel me? And he already said it. The niggas want what the bitches want. And then he always had something for you to think about and just really mind-boggling bullshit. And then you got something like, what's your phone number? Who I dare any nigga to really come back and try to be like, get on that beat and be wavy about it. And just, I'm just saying, like, the nigga went hard on that beat. Some niggas would have just skipped over to be like, I can't do that. You know, none of you niggas, sorry ass niggas, can do that. But anyways.
Yeah, I don't know none of your bars, Nas. I respect you, but I just don't know. You can't act, though. In Belly, I was like, him and T-Bob scenes was horrible. Anyway, that nigga's not no juice. But in poetry, none of the Tupac movies, like, you know what I'm saying? But
most of them.
Biggie was hard as fuck. I ain't hating on you and Jay-Z. I ain't taking nothing from you and Jay-Z, because y'all got some lines that I fuck with.
Only reason why I ever even hated on Biggie and why I would even put Biggie below the pedestal is just that I felt like, and I feel like this about a lot of New York rappers or East Coast rappers, you guys kind of put yourself in this box with regards to the music. And I feel like when you really listen to West Coast rappers, there's not necessarily a sound unless you are like the gangster rapper. So West Coast rappers don't necessarily have a sound or a regional situation. They can go across the board and do music with people in the South, the East Coast, and still get with it. You guys always jump on them beats that still sound East Coast. So
that's supposed to do, though.
No, I'm not saying you're supposed to do that. I'm just saying I would like to see you guys
some of
more.
That's cool. I wish they did that more, though. Everybody just stayed, but it's not like that.
I just want people to be diverse so that when you want to talk about.
The nerds in.
I'm just saying, if you got bars, you should be able to jump in on everything. He challenged me on War of the Roses.
I can do it. Here's the difference between I'm not a rapper, I'm an artist. Like, I got the Charisma Blues coming out. It's like, it's a blues album. It's a blues album with a nigga with swagger. So it's Charisma Blues. Like, you know what I mean? I can do that. I can do what the fuck ever. I can do some R&B shit. I can do some backpack shit. But I just, reality rap is more of my thing, and not showing any type of suckiness in me in my lyrics. That's just where I don't have a positive message to preach, because I try to preach and talk to motherfuckers and they don't even listen when you're speaking to them. So, you know, you gotta have some notoriety and fame, I guess, to get the message across on that type of. But with me displaying myself, I'm speaking on what I seen, what I did.
Yeah, experiences, what you know.
That's just me. That's just the route I took in music. I understand people have other routes. They, like, now I'm just doing the Charisma Blues thing. That's the fact. I'm not, no more rap for me. Retired on that. But, you know, that's where I'm at with it. Just where you want to take it and your approach. But me, I never gave a fuck about what nobody else thought about me like that, for me not to go ahead. Like, you care about what people think, but then after a certain point, you just don't give a fuck no more. Like, matter of fact, this is what I am. I'm being who I am. I'm doing who I am. This means I'd rather you hate me for who I am than love me for what I'm not. And I'm not going to be what you want me to be.
Matter of fact, sometimes you get these critics jump on board and want to talk to you about shit. When's the last time you fucking wrote a bar? Ask yourself that. If somebody's going to criticize us, or any rapper, or artist for that matter, then you need to be doing this shit your damn self. That's all I'm saying.
Shit, I'm on my mind to build my own shit. Do your own shit, do your own craft, make your own destiny. Because if you don't do that, you're gonna allow somebody to dictate where you need to go. So if you don't take control of your own shit, then you don't need to do it anyway. Because that's not where it is right now. Most you can get is a motherfucking publicist. You really don't need a motherfucking manager. You should be able to talk for yourself. If you're fucking smart, talk your own business. Right? So why the fuck you need somebody when they not even, they're, them motherfuckers is waiting for motherfuckers to get hot just to take whatever the fuck you making. That's what signing is nowadays. Shit. So you don't even need them. Might as well get 90 to 100% of your shit instead of getting 40. So who wants to sign with anyone? Nigga. A partnership is all you could, all I would ever do. I would never sign my life over to somebody so they can dictate my direction or where I need to go, how I need to dress, what songs I should put out first. No, we got the control now. The game is forced that way, that we have the control now. So if we don't step up and take our own control, that means we don't want to do that shit anyway, man. But you know what? I'm gonna bust my ass and grind hard and work, at least work it out. So I don't look back and be like, man, I wish I, you know, shoulda, coulda, woulda, shit.
Well said.
Wait, hold up. Till she throw up. Hold up. Wait, hold up. Put it in her liver, make her shiver till she throw up. Wait, hold up. Till she throw up. Wait, hold up. Nigga.